Well, as you can see, we're taking our focus today off of animal adaptations, and we're going to move back to plants. And so specifically, what we need to look at is what a plant needs to survive and the life cycle it goes through from seed to the germination of that seed, which you saw in the video there. That's a word that's going to be on your test, germination, when that seed begins to grow into a plant. And so germination is that seed beginning to grow. Don't forget that. But then it grows into a plant. Eventually, it produces its own seeds, and those seeds are spread, then new plants grow. And so, during that process, for a plant to be able to produce seeds, to produce fruit, you remember what that's called? We did a lot of review on it last week during our review week. It's photosynthesis, isn't it? A plant takes in three things and gives off two things. Do you remember what the three things it needs? It takes in carbon dioxide from the air. You're breathing it out right now. Every time you exhale, you're exhaling carbon dioxide. So plant breathes that in. It needs sunlight, obviously, for photosynthesis. And then it needs, what's the other one? What is it? It's water, isn't it? It needs water. So carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight to produce fruit. So a plant needs those three things, and then it gives off two things. One of them is sugar, also called glucose, and then oxygen that you're breathing in right now. So we and those plants, we're kind of friends. They breathe in out what we exhale, and we breathe in what they give off during photosynthesis. So plants are very important for us so that we can have plenty of air to breathe. Today we're going to look at a text called A Plant Puzzle. This is from ReadWorks, and so we're going to read this together, and then as always, you can go back and look at the text again to help you answer the question. So this reviews plant life cycles and photosynthesis. So we're going to read this, and then you'll have some questions to answer today. Okay, so let's get started reading A Plant Puzzle. Living things like plants, animals, and people need energy to survive and grow. People eat food for energy, but most plants use energy that they get from sunlight. When you look at plants, such as a tree, flower, or grass, what do you see? You might notice their stems, trunks, branches, leaves, roots, flowers. But how do they grow? What are they made from? How did the plant make those parts? Well, life is a puzzle in many ways. People don't all agree on how life started or why it exists, yet a simple way of thinking about how plants grow is to think of the plant itself as a piece of a larger puzzle. Each plant is a part of its unique environment. Different environments could be oceans, forest, deserts, or cities. Do plants grow in oceans? Sure they do. Ever heard of seaweed? Yeah. Each environment also has its own climate, which is partially based on how much sun and rain an area receives every year. Since only certain plants grow in hot, cool, wet, or dry climates, each environment is made up of different types of plant life. A desert may grow palm trees and cacti, while a forest may grow tall pines or oak trees. You know, when we were doing that lesson on animal adaptations, those birds back on Monday, the environment they live in, they're adapted for. Plants are adapted to the environment they live in as well. In order for a plant to grow, it needs three very important puzzle pieces. We just talked about them: water, carbon dioxide, and light, sunlight. Plants use their roots to take in water from the ground. They use their leaves to take in sunlight and carbon dioxide from the air. Plants use these three puzzle pieces to make their own food in a process called photosynthesis. Using the energy from the sun, plants convert water and carbon dioxide into sugar. The sugar feeds the plant's growth from a seedling into an adult. In the process, the plant releases oxygen into the air. Another important piece to the growth of many plants is soil. Using their roots, plants take in nutrients from the soil that help them grow. Giving a plant a spot in clean soil is important to make sure that it doesn't absorb anything harmful from the dirt. Plants make their food from carbon dioxide, water, and light. They use this food to grow stems, trunks, roots, branches, leaves, and flowers. Now, when you look at a tree, a flower, or even a blade of grass, you can see all the pieces of the plant and how the entire puzzle fits together. And I hope that puzzle is coming together in your mind, that you can learn more. You have learned more now about how plants grow from seeds all the way to making their own seeds, and how photosynthesis is such an important part of that process of plants growing and be able to produce their own food. We'll learn later on in a chapter that plants are called producers because they produce or make their own food. Okay, well, it's your turn to do some investigation now. I want you to go and answer the questions about this text. You please come back to this text and find your answers in the text. Don't just guess. Find the answers in the text and make a great grade on today's assignment. You can go do it now. I'll see you later.